What do sunsets have in common with global warming? And how can we create a sunset inside of a glass? Welcome to Corey's Curious Science for the Global Science Show. In part one of this experiment, we'll be exploring the science of sunsets by creating one in our very own glass. Then in part two, we'll explore how understanding the science of sunsets can help us understand global warming. For this experiment, you'll need some water, some glasses, a bit of milk, a straw, and a torch. First, we're going to pour some water into each of our glasses. Next, we're going to drop 0 drops of milk into the first glass, 3 drops of milk into the second glass, and 6 drops of milk into the third glass. And I'm going to use a straw to do this. And finally, let's give them a bit of a stir so all the milk and water is stirred together. Now comes the exciting part. I'm going to close the curtains, turn off the light, and have a look at our glasses of water under some torchlight. Let's have a look at our first glass of water, which doesn't have any milk in it. There's nothing too exciting going on here. You can see that it's just clear like it usually is. But I wonder what will happen if we put it over the one with 3 drops of milk in it. Let's try it. Ooh, you can see there's some interesting colors in this glass. It's kind of bluish at the top, but kind of reddish or orangey down the bottom. Now let's try our final one, which had 6 drops of milk in it, and see if this is any different. Wow, so the colors are even stronger on this one. It's quite blue at the top and really quite red down the bottom. And this red down the bottom reminds me a lot of the sunset. But where do all the colors come from if we had a white torchlight? I'll give you a clue. Try this experiment for yourself. But instead, try putting the torch at different points around the glass. So in front of the glass, behind the glass, to the side, and see if there's any difference in the colors you see. When you're ready, check out part two to see the science of sunsets and how they relate to global warming. Remember, there's instructions in the description if you want to try it at home. Happy sciencing!